All right, so the next step is that we're gonna cut the boards, the front, the spine, and the back boards for the book, because it's a book and books have covers. So we're going to cut the covers. And just watch for now. So the first thing that you always do when you take out a new piece of board is mark the grain direction. And when we make books, it's important that the grain be aligned with the spine of the book, okay? So in other words, here's your book, and the boards will be in the same direction. The grain of the boards will be in the same direction as. So you'll need your one, two, and three board templates for this. So the first thing that you're going to do is take your book and set it right at the edge of your board. And so I'm gonna get, and I'm gonna mark that. So I have a mark of the width of my spine. I'm gonna take my one board thickness template and add one to that. So the width of your spine piece is the width of your spine book, the spine of your book, plus one board thickness. So that's the back piece, that's the back board, okay? Now, obviously, in a book, all of the boards are the same height, right? Or the same length. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my book and I'm going to set it so that this edge is aligned with the bottom of the book. And I'm gonna mark how tall my book is, okay? And then, once I've done that, you have a choice. If you mark it three, if you use your three, that will give you 1.5 board thicknesses at the top and the bottom, which looks nicer. But if you want to give yourself room for error, then do four board thicknesses. But I'm going to do three because I feel pretty confident. And so I'm going to take that height that I just measured and add three board thicknesses. And that's going to be the height of all the front cover, the back cover, and the spine, okay? So then I'm going to cut that whole piece, okay, because I'm going to cut the front cover, the back cover, and the spine all out of that single piece. And that will make sure, that will ensure that all of my boards are the same height, okay? So I'm going to line it up with that mark that I just made. Now here's one of those cases where it's not aligned completely with a line here. So rather than align it here with a line, I'm going to make sure that all of those rectangles are the same size, those little rectangles, because it can't go all the way to the line because my measurement is there. So it's on a horizontal line, and I look and see that all of those rectangles are the same, so I know it's in the right spot. And then making sure that I'm putting a lot of pressure on this, and I'm pulling the blade slightly that way, I can cut it. I'm gonna make sure that stays still, because if it slips, then your boards won't all be the same, okay? So the first thing that I'm gonna do is cut the spine that I measured. The reason that I'm doing that is because I have all this to hold on to. If I end up weighing, then I'll have to cut it like that, and chances are I'll cut my finger off, okay? So I cut the spine piece first. And so again, I'm lining it up. So there's my mark for the width of the spine. Again, the width of the spine is the width of your text block spine plus one board thickness, okay? So, and then again, I'm checking those rectangles, those vertical rectangles, and holding it in place. I'm actually gonna go a little bit closer to the edge, pulling that a little in this direction, cut the spine, okay? Oh yes, the width of the boards. Okay, so now I need the front cover and the back cover. Now, the width of those is the same width as my text block, okay? So I'm gonna mark that and cut that. So exactly the same width, this dimension to that dimension. Not adding any board pieces or anything. Okay. Okay, so I've got that. Same. Cut that. and then mark that. Cut it. Now, if your measurements are exact, you should have enough to do all the front cover, back cover, and the spine. Might happen that you run out of board. If that happens, you'll just have to cut another board that's the same height. But I have enough. So, enough plus a little more. Okay, I'm gonna line that one up. And I wanna make sure that these are exactly the same width as each other. And obviously those will all be the same height because they're all cut out of the same board. So again, the height of these boards is the height of your text block plus three board thicknesses, the same width as your text block. This is the width of my spine plus one board thickness. So you want to check those and make sure that they're all right. One common mistake is, for some reason, sometimes students like have their spine piece that wide. So make sure that it's only as wide as the text block spine plus one board thickness. Okay. So then you're going to hold on to those. And when we get those cut, I'll tell you what the next step is. So there's three cutters. So those who are finished obviously are going to move forward with the cutting boards.
Wait, could you say that? So the spine is like a text block plus one board thickness, and what's the height again?
Sure.
We're trying to write it down. So
yeah, that's okay. So the height of the boards is the height of the text block plus three board thicknesses.
Okay, cool.
Three board thicknesses. The boards themselves, spine, front, back covers, front and back cover are the same width as the text block.
Okay.
And then the spine obviously is the same height as the front and back cover. And the width of that is the width of the spine plus one board thickness.
Cool.
Anybody need me to repeat that?
No.